So it's the same old slide which we had shown earlier when we started with the topic of finding out the AT crop, what are the calculation procedures. And we had said that we can do this by taking three different steps. We have already taken care of the first step, which is the effect of climate. We had mentioned that if we can delineate the effect of climate and from the effect of the crop characteristics, then our problem will be simplified. That is what has been recommended by FAO, and we have taken into consideration the effect of climate by finding out the reference crop evapotranspiration. This has been done by taking into consideration the ET naught. So this we have dealt with in great length. We have looked at all the methods which are available to find out the ET naught value, and we have also looked at what are the data requirements of those methods. Having done so, let's now go on to the next step, which is to incorporate the effect of crop characteristics. Because once we have found out the ET naught, ET naught is only a reference evapotranspiration, which is in this particular case, the way we have considered, is for grass. And we have taken that into consideration because of the fact that the grass can be controlled, in the sense you can control the length of the, the size of the grass. You can ensure that all those factors which are influencing the crop characteristics, they remain constant. So in the case of grass also, the effect of the crop characteristics is taken care of, but the only difference is that that effect is a constant effect. That is why we are calling it a reference crop evapotranspiration. Okay, but that is not the ultimate aim. We have that is only a wire media. That is only one of the intermediate steps. We wanted to find out the ET crop, and that too for not only one crop, for different crops. And when you are looking at a particular area, it is not necessary that you will have the same crop throughout the area. The area might be having growing various crops, starting with the grain crops, the fodder crops, there can be some tree plantations, there can be some other type of vegetable crops can be there. So all different mix of crops can be prevailing in that particular area, and we want a methodology by which we can find out what is the crop evapotranspiration for each individual crop. So to attain that, we had said that we can use these three different steps, and we have taken care of so far the first step, where we have found out the effect of climate in terms of the reference crop evapotranspiration. Okay. Next, today we'll start with the effect of the crop characteristics. That how we incorporate the effect of the crop characteristics into the evaluation of ET crop. And that we had mentioned in the beginning, that is done by defining a crop coefficient. This is what is known as crop coefficient. This crop coefficient KC, what we are saying is that now, since we know ET naught, and ET naught can be related with the ET crop through a coefficient, which is the crop coefficient, and which can change from crop to crop. We'll look at much it can change, how we find out the values of these crop coefficients for various crops, and what are the other factors which influence this crop coefficient. In general, this is a slide which gives the overall variation for majority of the crops with respect to what you get as the reference crop evapotranspiration. Now here on the x-axis we have this ET grass, which is nothing but can be used as ET zero or ET naught. So this is the reference crop evapotranspiration. If you compare the crop evapotranspirations of some other crops, you will find that the variation is on both sides. There are some crops which are having more evapotranspiration requirements than the grass. There are some crops which are having less evapotranspiration requirements than the grass. So all this is a line which is a 45 degrees line, and which shows the grass. If you have any crop which is the ET crop of that crop, if it is falling on this line, that means is equivalent to the ET naught, or the evapotranspiration of that crop is equal to the evapotranspiration which is experienced by the grass. Look at this group, which is the group containing cotton, tomatoes, sugar beet, maize, apple. This group has a value of ET crop which is more than the value of ET naught or the ET grass, and that's why if you take the ratio is greater than 1. So in these crops, and there's a lot of variation, you have to understand at this stage that it's not necessary that one particular crop will have a specific level of ET evapotranspiration value. It is also influenced by many other factors. So this is a curve, or this is a plot which shows the variation of ET grass with respect to the ET crop or different crops. But there is a lot of scattered in this variation, which accounts for many other factors, which are for example, the cotton of a particular area, the species of cottons. There can be many species of cotton which are prevailing. So when you say cotton, is not that it will have a unique value of evapotranspiration. It will also depend on where it is grown, what is the growth period of that particular crop, okay, what is the sowing date. So all those things, all those factors will have a look in a moment. Now this gives you the overall picture, what can be the variation. For example, the pineapple and citrus, these are the crops which are having a value of evapotranspiration much less than that of the grass under the similar conditions. Here you are assuming that the conditions, the climatic conditions are similar, only then the comparison can be possible. This is because of the characteristics of these crops. For example, in the case of a pineapple, the stomata, the leaves of the pineapple are such that the stomata closes during the daytime. So the loss of moisture through the stomata which takes place, that is reduced considerably, and that is why the evapotranspiration value is also influenced. Similarly, in the case of citrus trees, all the citrus trees which include orange, or all these which have the citrus qualities, all these trees, you will find that their leaves are waxy. The formation of the leaves are such that the evapotranspiration is much lower. So they are hardy trees, they can survive. So the species of the various crops will be influencing the evapotranspiration rate, and that is depicted in this particular slide. So it is not necessary that when you are comparing with the grass, is the grass is not the one which is the lowest evapotranspiration crop. There are crops which are having much lower values of evapotranspiration. Now here I have tried to give you the range that how the ET crop varies from crop to crop. For some of the crops I have just mentioned that what is the seasonal evapotranspiration requirement in terms of millimeters. Now if you look at alfalfa, it ranges from 600 to 1500 millimeters. Here we are trying to look at the total value throughout the season of the crop. Banana 700 to 17, beans 250 to 500. So the variation is a real considerable variation from crop to crop, and within the crop also you will find that within the crop, if you divide the total season into some separate segments which we call the growth periods or the stages of the crop growth, you will again find that the difference is there. So when you talk of the KC value, here we come back to the KC because that is what we are interested in. The crop coefficient is something which is not a fixed factor, is not a fixed coefficient. It will change from crop to crop, it will change from stage to stage within the crop also. So that variation is what we are interested in. There will be a variation on in KC from depending on the crop type, and KC will also vary with respect to the stages of crop. Okay. There are some other factors also which will affect the crop coefficient. We have said the crop characteristics is one factor which will affect the crop coefficient. The crop planting or sowing date. Now this is a factor. What happens in a crop? If you delay its planting, the whole sequence of its growth changes. It affects the whole sequence of its growth process because of the variations in temperatures, because of the variation in climate which are encountered in that particular area. So the crop planting or the sowing date might change the growth process of the crop, and thereby the KC will also be affected. The length of the growing season, again, different under different environments, you will find that the same crop might be having a different growth period. The climatic conditions, how do they vary? We have looked at the impact of the climatic conditions on the ET naught. But again, it depends how we are considering those climatic conditions. Are we considering them on the average basis? Are we considering them on the actual basis? So those climatic conditions, their variations, will have some impact on the KC values, which will have a look at each of these factors, how they affect. Then the frequency of rain or irrigation, that means the availability of water. What is the moisture availability in the soil? That will influence the KC values. Because KC value is nothing but is a factor which is relating the evapotranspiration with some base evapotranspiration, which is the ET naught. So the opportunity of evaporation, evapotranspiration, evaporation as well as transpiration. This opportunity will be dependent highly on the availability of moisture that we have seen in the case of our topic, where we had tried to look at the relationship between the crop, the water and the soil, and we had seen that how the stresses change, how the moisture utilization changes with the availability and all those things. So the availability of rain or the irrigation water in the soil or the moisture availability in the soil will influence the KC factor also. Now here one example has been taken to highlight some of these factors. This is a case where sugar beet is the crop and the KC values have been shown here for the same crop but having different growing seasons. Now this is the sugar beet which is grown in the autumn and spring and summer. In all these three cases, the total growth period is different. In this case, it takes 230 days for the sugar beet. In this case, 200 days. In this case, 160 days. And this is because of the fact that their climate is different. Now within this, for each individual case, you'll find that here is depicted that how the KC actually changes when you make the water available. So when the conditions are wet, suppose you have given this is the initial moisture condition. This is the initial moisture level. Now the KC will keep on varying, the actual coefficient will keep on varying with respect to the moisture availability. It will keep on reducing as the moisture reduces. Because in that case, what happens? The evapotranspiration activity is influenced because of the moisture availability. The moisture is not available, though the potential is there for the moisture to deplete from the soil. But the crop is not in a position to make that depletion possible because of the higher stress, because of the deficit which is available in the moisture, the soil. Thereby, that is taken account of by the KC factor. So the KC is the one, the crop coefficient value reduces. So again, if you apply, this is the amount of irrigation water, you have brought the level up to a level which might be close to the field capacity level. So you have applied another irrigation at this particular stage. Again, the KC value goes up and the same continues. So if you keep on applying more irrigation or there is natural rain, then you will find that this KC will fluctuate with respect to the moisture availability of the soil. And this is the firm line which is shown here. This is basically the average value of KC, because in actual practice when you are using these values, it might not be possible to keep track of the actual moisture conditions. You are trying to use a value which is an average value of KC, and this gives the variation of KC and this total growing season. Okay. Now in the other case, you'll find that in this particular case, the time for maturity has reduced. So the same thing is also true in this particular case also, and the third case also is the same trend is same, but the time to maturity is much reduced because of the different climatic conditions. That happens, and it happens because of the various, in this case, it happens because of the moisture availability. It also happens because of the different species of the same crop are under different climates, and you will have to find out the KC values, which are relevant values, which are appropriate values under those conditions. So that is what is the important factor which you'll have to look at. Now this is again the same slide which we had looked at earlier, that in the case of field and vegetable crops, in general we can divide the total growth period of a crop into four stages: initial stage, the crop development stage, the mid-season stage, and the harvest or the late season stage. Now these four different stages, in literature you will find that these stages, the data are available for most of the crops. What are the various stages, what is their, what are their lengths, and if they are not available, the local universities or the local research organizations which are indulging in this particular area of agriculture, they will have those values. So these are the values which are not difficult to get. Once you have these values, the data on these basic growth periods of the crops, you can develop the KC values using the various procedures which are recommended by FAO. It has been found that for these four different stages, let's first discuss only for the field and vegetable crops, because the evaluation of the KC values for other crops which are having different characteristics is also different. There is this FAO 24 which we are referencing for this particular purpose. It has all these details given. They have recommended the growth periods for different crops under different conditions, and they have tried to cater to the total requirements around the globe, and they have also given the procedure which should be used to construct your own KC values or your KC variation when you use a particular crop. So that's what we are trying to look at. Now this is a graph which gives the average KC value for initial crop development stage for the field and vegetable crops. The very first stage, it gives the values which are a function of at which frequency you are making the moisture available. Let's look at the initial stage. What happens in the initial stage? Your only activity is the activity of sowing. The size of the plants will be very small by the end of the stage also. So which is the activity which is the most important activity during this period? It is basically the activity of evaporation. There is hardly any transpiration which becomes the part of the total evapotranspiration. So the evapotranspiration is predominantly governed by the evaporation activity, evaporation from the soil. And it's quite obvious that the evaporation from the soil will be a function of the moisture availability in the soil. Whereas in the other cases, when the crop grows and the land or the soil on which the crop is growing, in some cases it might be totally shadowing the land. So there will be the reduction in the evaporation activity will be taking place as the crop grows. The higher the canopy formation will be there of the crop, and it will also depend on what is the type of crop, how much shading it can or how much coverage it can give to the ground. But in general, you can visualize that the activity of evaporation evaporation will reduce as the time passes, as you go into the next stages of the crop growth. But in the beginning, in the very first stage, the major activity will be the activity of evaporation. And that's the reason that the average occurrence of irrigation or the availability of the natural water to drain will be the governing factor in the case of the initial stage. And that is what has been recommended here, that in this particular stage, the KC values versus the ET naught in millimeters per day during the initial stage that has been plotted and is varying with respect to the average recurrence interval of the rain or of irrigation. Let's have a look. This top curve belongs to a recurrence interval of 2 days. Whereas the next one is the 4-day recurrence interval, and the next one is 7 days, and so on. This one is 7 days, the next one is 10 days and 20 days. Okay, in this case, let's have a look. What we are saying indirectly is that if you are making the moisture available very frequently, then knowing the reference crop evapotranspiration, for this, a KC value will be very high value. So if you have 7 millimeters per day as the ET naught value and your moisture availability is every second day you are making the moisture available either through irrigation or through rainfall as a material, then the KC value will be 0.8. On the contrary, if you are making the water available after 7 days and the ET naught is the same, 7 millimeters per day, then your KC value is 0.6, is low. Again, because of the reason that the evaporation activity will be much less. So since that is the dominating segment of the ET crop, so your ET crop will be much less. If the moisture availability is less, the ET crop will be less, and that has been taken care of by this particular graph. So the lower the recurrence interval of the irrigation or rain, you will get a lower KC value because the evaporation activity will be influenced. It will be much difficult for the moisture to leave the soil through evaporation, and thereby it'll influence the KC factor. So your KC value will keep on reducing. Okay. So using this representation, you can find out what is the KC value for the field and vegetable crops during the initial stage of the crop development. For the remaining stages, for stage number 3 and 4, these are the stages when you are towards the maturity. You are at a level when the crop is fully mature. These stages are influenced by the relative humidity and the prevailing wind. So there is a relationship which has been given, it has been recommended after they have collected the data from all recommended these values for different climatic conditions, and I have just picked up some of the values just to show you that these are the tables which are available. You can refer to FA24, and I'll also make the tables available to all of you, all these standard tables which are available in FA24. I'll provide you a set, and that can be, these can be used. So in this case now for barley, for stage 3, when the wind is between 0 to 5 meters per second and relative humidity is greater than 70%, you are having a value of Kc of 1.05. The value changes to 1.1 if the wind speed is higher, is between 5 and 8. Similarly, if the relative humidity was lower, it was less than 20%, then your Kc value would have been higher, because there is more absorption capacity in the air. There can be the activity of evapotranspiration can be enhanced, and that's why that can be taken care of by a value which is a higher value of Kc. Similarly, if the wind is again of a higher magnitude, then you will still get a value of Kc which is higher than this value or these values also. Similarly, you will find that between the stage 3 and 4, there is a drastic change. In the case of stage 4, which is the last stage when the crop is mature, is the stage which is the harvesting stage, you will find that the requirement of evapotranspiration reduces drastically, because the crop doesn't need that the moisture any further, and it goes down from 1.05 to 0.25. But again, there is no hard and fast rule. It is again a function of which crop you are talking about. What are the characteristics of the crop? If you look at between barley and beans, in this case, the Kc value has reduced from 1.05 to 0.25. Whereas in this case, in the case of beans, it has reduced only from 0.95 to 0.85. So the reduction in the Kc value is a function of which crop we are talking about, what are the characteristics of the crops, how much is the moisture requirement of the crop, and that is depicted, very well depicted here. Most of the grain crops you will find that the requirement reduces drastically. For example, in the case of wheat also, from 1.05 it goes down to 0.25. But in the most of the vegetable crops, you will find the difference between stage 3 and stage 4. Kc values, they might not be that much different. The variation will be very minor variation. So which shows, which indirectly dictates the water requirements. We are looking at, we have the ultimate aim is how much irrigation water you will need if the natural water is not available. So these things will throw light on the requirements, because you should supply that much as is required, and that is what we are trying to go through in this total process. So suppose this is what I was referring to, that is again I have picked up the length of growing season and the top development stages of some of the field crops. These are the crops which I have just taken, the barley, wheat and oat. They have the same growing length, the growing season length, but they vary from, if you talk in terms of the same crop but they are being grown in different environments, then their length can also change. That's what we have seen in the case of Central India. The wheat is grown in November, and these are the lengths of four stages. The first stage, 15 days length, second stage, 25 days, third stage, 50 days, and the fourth day is 30 days. So the total length of the growing period is 120 days. But the same wheat or barley, when it's grown in East Africa and the highland, the month is July, and the length of the different growing stages, they change. It's 15, the same in this case, but this has gone to 30, there is 65, there is 40, and the total length is now 150 days in place of 120 days, which we see in India. Similarly, in the case of beans, for different areas, all this is made available by FAO. They have compiled this data and they have consolidated this data, and that data is available. So the length of the growing season is also something which is available with you. You can use that information to construct the variations of KC. Now, having done so, let's look at how we proceed. Suppose this is now, this is the, we have seen that the, if we represent the period of growth of the crop, and we can mark that this is the period, this is the initial stage, or stage 1 of a specific crop, any crop you can choose, and then the next stage is the second stage is the crop development stage, so you know the length of this stage also in terms of days. That's number 2. Then you have the mid season, mid season stage, and you have the last stage, which is the late season stage. Now, having known these four durations, which we have found that they are available for a specific area, for a specific crop, once we know these, we can, then the recommended procedure is that here we are going to find out the crop coefficient. This is what we are interested in knowing, that how this varies from stage to stage, or for this total period of the crop, how the KC values vary. We have also noted down that the KC value for this initial stage, we know that there is a value which is available depending on this variation which we have just looked at, and the initial, depending on the reference interval, if we know the climate, if it is rain, which is the input, or if the input is the irrigation, then what is the reference interval of that irrigation which you are using in that particular area. Knowing that, and knowing the AT naught, because AT naught is already computed using one of the methods which we have recommended. So knowing the AT naught and the reference interval of the moisture availability, we can read out the value of KC during that initial stage. Suppose this is the value which we have obtained, and this value will be, you can say that this varies from 1.3, and in between this is the scale which is used. So on that scale you find out what is the value of the KC during this initial stage, and we can assume that this variation is throughout this initial stage, the KC value remains similar or remains same during that stage. That is the assumption which is made here in constructing this variation. Then we come down to the late season stage. In the late season stage, we have again seen that for the specific crop which we have which we are looking at, we can use the information available and find out what is the value of the KC values for the specific environment. If we know the RH minimum, if we know the wind speed, we can find out which is the value, which is the relevant value for stage 3 as well as stage 4. So those two values are known, and we can draw them in the form of those two points. This is one point, and in the case of the stage 3, there is another point which we can say that this is the point. The values which are the corresponding values which we can read from that table. So these two values are written down. Now the recommended procedure is that we draw a line parallel to the x-axis from that point which is for the mid-season stage. So we draw a horizontal line through that point for the total mid-season stage, and for this is the stage, total stage, and then we join these. This is the end of the initial stage. We join this and this, and on this side we join this and this. So this KC value is plotted at the end of the fourth stage, and you join the point which is corresponding to the end of the mid-season with that point. Now this gives you a variation, and then you can even because you know that the variation is not occurring in this manner. There are some abrupt changes which cannot occur in nature. So there has to be some smooth transition from one stage to another stage. And you can draw approximately a shape which is a smooth curve between these points, or you can even have it . This is the variation which you can take as the representative variation of KC value. And this can be used, this can be constructed for any crop which is the vegetable or the grain crop, and you can use these four known values. What we are assuming is that between this stage, initial stage, and the crop development, the mid-season stage, during the crop development stage, there is a variation of KC value from a known value of KC during the initial stage up to the mid-season stage, and we are trying to use that because this is a very steep change. And during the other periods, we have some representative values available. We are making use of those values to give a uniform variation, which can be used now to find out how the crop evapotranspiration will vary from stage to stage within the same crop. On the contrary, if you want to use a mean value for the whole season of the crop, even that can be done by taking a representative value, which is a mean value of this variation. But it depends on what is your requirement. For example, if your requirement is to go in for the design of the irrigation system, where you are looking at the values which are to be used on the average basis, because at that time when you are going for the design, you have to look at many other factors. One major factor is the size of the distribution system. If you try to cater to all the requirements in terms of the extreme requirements, you might find that your size requirement of the carrying or the carrying capacity in the form of carrying capacities of the channels or the canals will become so huge that it might not be economically viable. So if that is the requirement, then you might have to look at some average values. You also have to bring in the risk factors. Do you want to take care of the extreme values always? Which means that even those situations which are experienced very infrequently, maybe once in 10 years or once in 15 years, if you take care of those extreme situations, extreme climatic conditions, then you had it. Because then the requirements of from the system requirement point of view, they will become very huge. Whereas if you are interested in utilizing this information in deciding what are the actual requirements in terms of the scheduling of irrigations, when you try to find out what are the requirements at a particular location of irrigation, then you might need the actual values of KC. How do they vary from time to time? Because when you talk of irrigation requirements, how much water is needed, you are talking in terms of the known climatic conditions. Are you here? And what we are saying is that when you are giving the irrigation, are you at this location in time or are you here? If you are here, your requirements are very small in comparison to what will be the requirement when you are here. So that is what the total business of scheduling is, that how much requirement of water is there, how you are going to supply that, in what quantities, at what timings. That will come to. At this stage, I thought it would be better if we can put some thinking in terms of how we are going to utilize this, how what significance this KC variation has in terms of the water management. Okay, any question? Thank you. Then we'll stop here and